Blackstone Audio presents The Souls of Black Folk by W.E.B. Du Bois. The Forethought. Herein lie buried many things, which, if read with patience, may show the strange meaning of being black here in the dawning of the 20th century. This meaning is not without interest to you, gentle reader, for the problem of the 20th century is the problem of the color line. I pray you then receive my little book in all charity, studying my words with me, forgiving mistake and foible for sake of the faith and passion that is in me, and seeking the grain of truth hidden there. I have sought here to sketch in vague, uncertain outline the spiritual world in which 10,000,000 Americans live and strive. First, in two chapters, I have tried to show what emancipation meant to them and what was its aftermath. In a third chapter, I have pointed out the slow rise of personal leadership and criticized candidly the leader who bears the chief burden of his race today. Then, in two other chapters, I have sketched in swift outline the two worlds within and without the veil, and thus have come to the central problem of training men for life. Venturing now into deeper detail, I have in two chapters studied the struggles of the massed millions of the black peasantry, and in another have sought to make clear the present relations of the sons of master and man. Leaving, then, the world of the white man, I have stepped within the veil, raising it that you may view faintly its deeper recesses, the meaning of its religion, the passion of its human sorrow, and the struggle of its greater souls. All this I have ended with a tale twice told but seldom written. Some of these thoughts of mine have seen the light before in other guise, for kindly consenting to their republication here in altered and extended form, I must thank the publishers of the Atlantic Monthly, the World's Work, the Dial, the New World, and the Annals of the American Academy of Political and Social Science. Before each chapter, as now printed, stands a bar of the sorrow songs, some echo of haunting melody from the only American music which welled up from black souls in the dark past. And finally, need I add that I who speak here am bone of the bone and flesh of them that live within the veil. W.E.B. Du Bois, Atlanta, Georgia, February 1st, 1903. 1. Of Our Spiritual Strivings. O water, voice of my heart, crying in the sand all night long, crying with a mournful cry. As I lie and listen, and cannot understand the voice of my heart in my side or the voice of the sea, O water, crying for rest, is it I? Is it I? All night long the water is crying to me. Unresting water, there shall never be rest till the last moon droop and the last tide fail and the fire of the end begin to burn in the west. And the heart shall be weary and wonder and cry like the sea, all life long crying without avail, as the water all night long is crying to me. Arthur Symons. Between me and the other world, there is ever an unasked question, unasked by some through feelings of delicacy, by others through the difficulty of rightly framing it. All, nevertheless, flutter round it. They approach me in a half-hesitant sort of way, eye me curiously or compassionately, and then, instead of saying...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.